You ever been in a place where you feel like you just can't do anything right? I think it's difficult when you're connected to people who can only see the wrong in you, can see you for not the person you're trying to be, but the person that you're coming out from being, where you're trying to be something new, but everybody that knew you keeps connecting you, tying you to who they can see the changes in themselves. They just cannot see them, can't identify. Don't want to leave alert that you've become different.
And I say things I can't take back. I don't know how to live.
The friendship is so undermined. It's undervalued. It's underequated a lot of the times. People don't identify with the reality of that there's more to life than just screwing people over and doing people wrong and worrying about you only today. When do we become friends so much so that you put their best interests ahead of your own ego? You don't even know if you can trust people in the church anymore. You can trust family. You ain't got no real friend. The only person you can connect to is the one inside of you, and this. And that's deceitful in itself because it's you turning against you. Talk to me today, but I find myself in John chapter 8 today where there's a woman being drugged through the street. They done brought up charges on. She's been caught in the act of adultery. And she will be seemingly, I committed this crime today. I think it's interesting how the people that are bringing her are the same people that's trying to manipulate him. He is sitting there about to teach to the church, teach to the people, help them, tame them, get them on the right way. And here come the other preachers trying to trap them up with something they've already set up. It's crazy when they set you up to set him up. You just become a casualty of war. It wasn't really something about you. You just got caught up at the wrong place at the wrong time. You involved in the crimes you involved in because you're connected to people that they wanted to get, they wanted to hurt, they wanted to kill. It wasn't about you. You just become a casualty of war, but don't mean it didn't hurt. So many attacks, you can go through so many clapbacks, you can go through so much of the fight until you let people drag you and you have nothing else to do, nothing else to say. You have no more strength to give to them today. Let them drag you because putting up a fight only gonna make it worse. Saying something only gonna give them more evidence of incidents of reason to drag you harder through. Don't even put up a fight no more. I'm talking to somebody who's tired being drugged through the street. Mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally. You psychologically drained. You ain't got no more else to give. You ain't got no more smiles to fake. You ain't got no more energy to be around people who would test you but not take you. I'm so tired. I've been being drugged for so long. I ain't got energy to care no more. You ain't mad, it's just that you should have caught me when I first put up a fight. But see, you wanted to wait and drag me all the way through all this stuff. If people had identified that you cared from the beginning, that they would understand your nonchalantness now is not being nonchalant. You just don't care. It ain't that you hate them, it ain't that you don't love them, it's that you just don't care. You done with it, you done exhausted all your energy, you done put the most to it that you can. You ain't extinguishing no more effort, you ain't expunging no more. You done got the best of me, the most of me, you done got my best years, my best time. You done got something I cannot replace. I'm not pouring more into this dead, empty place. You tired of being drugged in my emotions, drugged in my feelings, being drugged in my portrayal of truth, trying to move you. And all you can identify with is when I heard them talk to me today. But when somebody else would manipulate you and you come and bring that, pour that onto me. You've been dragging. You've been dragging for years. And they drag you in the presence of church, and church judges you. I'm I'm talking about you. You done been through the mud already. You done been through the attack already. You done been through hell and high water. You done seen trial and stress. You done been manipulated. You done been through the duress. You done been in jail. You done been through all this hell, and only to come to church are the very ones who would contradict you, crucify you, kangaroo court you, trump up charges on you based off of what they heard and not the evidence of what appears to be in the great story of the word. Jesus starts writing in the dirt. They try and tell him, cancel service, shut church down. This is ridiculous, because we found somebody who's on a deacon board. We found somebody who's a mother. We found somebody who is positively posting on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Yahoo. I'm talking about they found you right where you were, trying to pretend like you saved, trying to pretend like you all about God. They found you and threw you in front of them and told God Jesus about you. Started writing in the dirt. He didn't say anything. He just started writing. I came to tell somebody in the room, Jesus shows up in your picture and rewrites your. I'm talking to somebody who can identify that your history was, but because your God is omnipresent, he can go back to your past and rewrite things over, so that when they come up to the conviction, is that there is no indictment, there is no history, there is no conviction on your record. I came to tell somebody on today, somebody's criminal record is being expunged. Somebody has been trumped up charges on something you know you didn't do, but because of the people you were associated through, you would be falsely accused. God told me he is clearing up the cases. He is making sure that you get to your destined locations. He is going to make sure you come out all right in this fight. Do not give any sway way to the enemy today. Let him know by defining reason that God is rewriting your history. He's rewriting your record. He's rewriting the incident. He is rewriting. Jesus is found writing in the dirt. And he tells them, you who are without sin, throw the first one. Listen to me. He said, if you ain't never done nothing wrong, throw it. You ain't never smoked a little weed, throw it. You ain't never had sex without a condom, throw it. You ain't never cheated on your husband, throw it. I'm talking to somebody who's big and bad enough to throw it even though they got some stuff. Can you throw it in the face of God, knowing that if you throw it out there, he'll throw a bigger one back at you? I'm daring somebody to identify on today that I am a sinner, and I've been lost in my ways, but I've been saved through God's grace, and I can stand tall amongst anybody and say I am delivered even on today because of him who says, if you bad enough, if you big enough, him without sin, throw the first one. You got to be careful about putting your name in places that it does not belong. You are a child of the King. Identify with God writes in the dirt. That's where he does his best work. Make you inform you to be everything that you need to be for your destiny in this season.
He said,
where are your accusers? As she looked around and saw there was no one there. Says, I'm writing in the dirt. I don't see you. And Jesus looks up at her and says, You right? I don't see it either. I'm talking to somebody today who can identify with whatever you say that the Spirit of God is getting in alignment with on today. That if you don't see dead in your past, you absolute, if you don't see exes in your past, manipulating, who would cause you emotional stress, God said, you right, I don't see it either. I don't see no type of conviction. I don't see no type of eviction. I don't see no type of contradiction. I see no divorce. I see no mental, no physical, no resource abuse of your memory. I don't see it either. When people come at you in this season talking about all that stuff that they knew, you look at them folk and say, oh, who you talking about on them? I don't know what person you knew that you may be trying to rewrite my story. I don't know. I just can't see it. I can't see what you're talking about.